Good morning to all of you. Last class we have been discussed about Huygens IPS and about its construction, working theory, what do you mean by spherical abrasion, what do you mean by chromatic abrasion. These things we have been already discussed, and the working of the Huygens IPS also we have been discussed. So last class also I give a note regarding finding the cardinal points of Huygens IPS by using system of matrix. This note I given in last class. Today we are going to discuss. So previously we have been already studied that the system of matrix of combination of two lenses is 1 minus x by f1, x minus 1 by f1 minus 1 by f2 plus 1 by f1 into f2 1 minus x by f2. This x is nothing but, suppose this is the two combination of two lenses, so this distance is nothing but called as x, and this is the f1 first focal length, this is called the second focal length of the second lens, this is the focal length of the first lens, this is the focal length of the second lens. By this combination we found the system of matrix is this one. So as we have been saw in our discussion in that in case of high Huygens IPS, exactly same things is happening, that two lenses, that may be plano convex lens, but two this physical material, that is one lens, another lens, are placed with by a distance. Hence, this system of matrix, here system means two lenses combined or thin lenses separated by a distance. So now, its so-called system of matrix can be represented with the help of the generalized system of matrix. So for Huygens IPS that we have been discussed, focal length of a field lens is f1, which is three times greater than the focal length of IPS, which is, okay, in just a small words you can correct, which is three times greater than the focal length of the IPS. Let if f2 equal to f focal length of IPS, then f1 will be 3f, that is the focal length of the field lens. To free from all the abbreviations, all the disturbances, the distance between the two lenses has to be 2f, x is equal to 2f. That means the distance between the two lenses, means this distance should have to be 2f, and this is your field lens, this is your eye lens, because this side is your eye is there, so this is called the eye lens, this is called the field lens. Field lens is f1, eye lens is f2. If f2 is equal to f, then f1 is equal to 3f. And if we want to get free from abbreviations at the time of taking image or observing the image by magnification, we have to place the both the lenses with the distance x is equal to 2f. This is the condition of chromatic aberration and Huygens IPS construction. So distance between two lenses is x is equal to 2f. Then so from the matrix, if we are going to put all the values, then 1 minus x by f1 will be equal to 1 minus x is equal to 2f, f1 equal to 3f, so 1 by 3. Likewise, 1 minus x by f2 is minus 1, minus 1 by f1 minus 1 by f2 plus 1 by f1 into f2 will be equal to minus 2fy. 2 by 3f and the so-called x is 2f. So by putting all the values in this matrix, then what I am going to get, that is 1 by 3 2f minus 2 by 3f and minus 1. Okay, now in general the so-called system of matrix is A, B, C, D. Because why we are doing like this, we can by considering this one A, B, C, D, we can found exact value whenever we have to follow the table. May you have been remembered, I given one table. In that table, all the cardinal points formula are there. I am going to show you once. Wait, you have been forgot at the discussion, at the time of discussion of equivalent focal length of two thin lenses separated by some distance. Here we have been discussed at the end one table, which is, suppose first focal point is 1 by c, second focal point 1 by minus 1 by c, like that. So whenever we have to compare a, b, c, d in the general form of the system of matrix with any system of matrix of any eyepiece, then we can found the value of the cardinal points. So here in general the S is, system of matrix is A, B, C, D. So if I am going to compare with this, then A equal to 1 by 3, B equal to 2F, C equal to minus 2F by 3 and D is equal to minus 1. So now comparing both the matrix, we can found these things. Equivalent focal length. Now the cardinal points are, now here you have to write. Now the cardinal points are, now the cardinal points are, first cardinal point is belongs to equivalent focal length is 1 by f is equal to minus c. Okay, so 1 by f is nothing but minus c is minus 2 by 3f. So if I am going to put my c in, c is equal to minus 2 by 3f, then the answer will be the f will be 3 by 2 into f. Okay, the position of first principal point from the field lens. First principal, this is your field lens. I am going to put it should have to be plano convex. Okay, it is plano convex. So field lens is this is your Huygens eyepiece construction. This is your field lens and this is your eye lens. This is your eye lens. Okay, so first principal point will be here. That means left to the field lens. Okay, that is from the field lens, first principal point from the field lens, from the field lens to the left with the field lens. You have to follow the formula in the table. You can found that for first principal point the formula is d minus mu 1 by mu 2 by c. Here mu 1 equal to mu 2, so this will, this term will be 1 d minus 1 by c. So by putting the value of d is equal to minus 1 and c is equal to 2 minus 2 by 3f, we can found 3f. Okay, so from the point, from the center point, central point of this field lens towards left, if I will move first principal point, it is extremely sorry that it is first principal point, not focal point. First principal point means this side should have to be this side. So from this point to, if you have to move 3f distance, then you can find first principal point, right? Then position of second principal point from eye lens, that is this the eye lens. So from here to this side, if you have to move minus f distance, or as it is moving towards the left side, according to sine convention, it will be minus. So for the second principal point, we know that the formula is 1 minus a by c, 1 minus 1 by 3 by c is equal to minus 2 by 3f, is equal to minus f. So this is the position of second principal point from I lens. Okay, mistakenly I have been told that about focal point, but equivalent focal length we have been found this one. Okay, then we have been considered about first nodal point from the field lens, that is d minus 1 by c, we found 3f. And again second nodal point from the I lens, that is 1 minus a by c. So this c, this formula you can found from the that table. Okay, so 3f and 2f. So in the previous we discussed that for the first principal point we found 3f, for second principal point minus f. Here nodal point of first nodal point and second nodal point are both are coincided with first and second principal point respectively, because here from the nodal from this we found nodal point, first nodal point is 3f, and previously we found first principal point is also 3f. Likewise first second principal point is minus f, second principal nodal point also minus f. So hence both principal points are coincide with two nodal points. Okay, up to this much we have been I given you note. You just go through this video and check your note and correct correspondingly. Okay, thank you.